purposes for which the proceeds of debt issuance offered by such ordinance may be used to include the making of appropriations to the city's economic development authority, to be used by EDA to finance capital expenditures, or to make loans or grants to finance the capital expenditures for the purpose of promoting economic development.
Madam Chair, members of the Finance Economic Development Committee, and Chairman Judkins, DCAO for Finance and Administration. The ordinance before you is an amendment to an existing ordinance as was read by the clerk, 2011-70-94, which was adopted in May of 2011, and it authorized the issuance of bond and anticipated bond notes to finance the capital program, a CRP. Now, the proposed amended language is underlined and shown in your document on pages 2 and 4. The purpose of amending ordinance is to add another purpose for which proceeds of bond can be used to now include the making of appropriation to the city's economic development authority, to finance capital expenditures, or to make loans or grants to finance capital expenditures for promoting economic development. And that's shown on page 4 of the ordinance that you have before you.
Okay, thank you very much. The appropriation to the EPA, is there a dollar amount as it relates to that appropriation?
Not at this time. It doesn't define any appropriation. It just gives us the ability to do that as a strategy when we are trying to promote economic development, if that's what we'd like to do.
Okay. And the terms of the conditions of the EDA as relates to loans and grants would be spelled out?
Absolutely, and that would have to come back to you for approval anyway, if it happened. This just gives us a mechanism by which we can do that. It adds to our ability.
But it does not mean that the EPA is going to be responsible for the, they're not going to be the agency that is responsible for the entire 175.
No, the 175 million was a prior bond issuance when you did the original ordinance.
Right.
And that ordinance had in it the various purposes for which the proceeds of the bonds could be used. And so we just extended that purpose.
To add the EDA as an agency.
A vehicle by which we could use to promote economic development.
But before any appropriations actually make the EDA, no paper will have to come back to us.
That's correct.
All right. Thank you. Any questions? Any other questions, Mr. Sanders?
No, I just want to confirm that you've said this already. I just want to say it again.
Okay.
Sure, I understand it correctly. Once we grant this authority to you, any deal made under the conditions of this ordinance would still need to be brought to council for approval.
That's correct.
So we do not lose any oversight. We give you a tool to work a deal out if you guys think it's the best way of getting the deal done. And then you come to us and say, this is what we think is the best way. Please let us.
That's correct.
Any other questions? Mr. Collins.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The $175 million that we approved, that we authorized for those bonds, were set for schools and other city projects. And if my memory serves me correct, we had allocated three or four projects that were going to completely absorb this $175 million. What has changed?
When you actually gave us the authority to issue bonds, that time you looked at the capital project and the programs that were in there and said, these proceeds can be used for that. And that still is there. All we're saying, if and when there is a need for us to do economic development using the proceeds of this bond, we could do that through the city's economic development authority. So on page 4, it lists the proceeds of the bond should be used for various things, and it says that there. All we're doing is saying, here's another one, here's another strategy that could be used.
Let me back it up another way. My understanding budget. In fact, last year, the CIP budget, we added $12 million to the four schools that were being built because there were cost overruns associated with the projects. And I thought that $175 million was set aside primarily for the schools.
So why don't we look exactly what the ordinance says? Under number three, page four, it says, proceeds of the bonds shall be used by the city to finance in part, in whole or in part, a program of general capital improvement undertaken for the following purposes. It says construction, reconstruction, improvement and equipment of public schools, construction, reconstruction, improvements and equipment of various infrastructure needs, and it goes on. So that, and it's an, it was an estimate, it was a plan, the CIP, you know, we estimate, determine those projects that we're working on, the funds that we think we'll need at a given time to fund them, and so it said that that's what we could use this money for. So all we're saying now is another strategy that may help us in doing any economic development or any project would be to have the Economic Development Authority as a tool to use to do that.
And I guess the impasse I have with this conversation is I want to know what obligations we have already set aside with these bonds, these $175 million specifically, so I can understand how much money is set would be set aside for economic development.
There's no amount that's being set aside. It's only a strategy that is being put, a tool put in our tool bag to use if we need it.
I'm not computing, and I apologize. We have all these projects that are outstanding. We have costs associated with them. If my memory serves me correct, we're using short-term notes to finance these, ultimately go to the marketplace and get a single bond. And I thought this was the $175 million bond that we were going to use to do that.
At the time when you projected your some of the costs required in the CIP at that time, you did have all of those items in there. Those items, those were the types of items that you were looking at.
All right, and so, okay, let me back it up. What I think I would like to have happen is I would like to know where we are in relationship to the projects that we originally put in that short-term note that were ultimately going to be used in this $175 million bond. Because it makes no sense to me to add another thing to the pile if in fact we can't do it because we're already over-obligated with the dollars or we're going to have to borrow money, more money elsewhere. And the concern I have, and Mr. Marshall was kind enough, I think back in maybe it was Mr. Lassiter that actually made the presentation and that talked about where we were with our CIP and borrowing capacity in the city of Richmond. And we are reaching our debt ceiling limit if we haven't already reached it. And I think all of us have been watching that. But my question is, this 175 is obviously in that calculation. And I want to understand the projects associated with it, the dollars associated with it. And then I would feel more comfortable having the conversation about adding things to it. At this point, I'm not comfortable with that. So that's what I'm trying to ask.
Okay, I just want to, we can bring that information to you.
Yeah, I appreciate
it. We just wanted to reemphasize it's not changing any projects, it's just giving us some measures.
But I want to see what it's doing.
And we'll bring that to you on Monday.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Thank you.
Is there anyone who would not speak in favor of opposition to this paper? Okay, I'll bring it back to the room.
Good afternoon. My name is Philip Persinger. I'm a citizen of Richmond, Virginia. I would like to express my, my dissatisfaction. Not happy. In the chambers, there's no copies of the full language of the ordinances that you all are considering today. Maybe you have grown accustomed to not having citizens here at these meetings. I see there's about 15 people in the audience behind me, and all of them, except one that I know of, is a paid employee of the city. And I don't know how you expect people to make intelligent contributions to your analysis if we don't have access to the full language of the ordinances. I don't know if this is an item for the clerk or the chairperson, but when I used to come to meetings very regularly, there were normally two copies of the ordinances. And I know there's this available, and this is just a summary. It's not the full language of the ordinance. Therefore, I think it's not very helpful. That's just not my complaint. I have the same complaint for the previous paper that discussed the Boulevard development, and I hope this is something that can be corrected in the future. I think there should be two copies for public review. In case one person's using one, there's another available. Thank you for the opportunity to comment.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Duncan, what is the policy as regards to two papers being available for review?
We can provide two copies. Basically, that's one copy that's provided. As far as legally, the clerk's office only has to provide one public copy, but we can provide two.
Was there any copy provided?
Yes, there is. That was one.
Where was it?
And the assumption is that...
I know where it is, Mr. Persinger, but it's not out for you to confirm that. But I know where it is.
It's not available to the public.
It is available. And I can provide you but a copy.
I've got a copy. Thanks, Mr.
But it
Tyler.
Is available.
Okay, ma'am. I just want to, for the record, to, we can provide two copies, and then if two citizens have a copy in review, and then we still be left with no copy available. So if there's a copy that is there and a policy, I'm understanding from the clerk, we will provide two copies of all papers, full papers at any time, and they will always be on the front of the banner.
Yes,
there.
That is correct. We can take care of that.
All right. Thank you very much.
Is there anyone else who would like to speak in favor or in opposition to this paper? Hearing none, I will bring this paper back to the committee.
Okay, discussion, Mr. Tyler?
I mean for or against this paper because I don't have all the information. Two items we can do. One, we continue this for the next meeting and obtain the information. I didn't sense there was any time sensitive issue on this matter.
We can ask. Information is there a time sensitivity as it relates to this paper?
Excuse me, Chair. I was looking. But this item, we'd like for the item, of course, to move forward. I don't know if there's any economic development or any use for it right at this time, but we clearly want our two bags stocked with all Tuesday we need because we're constantly making decisions that impact our economic development in the area. That's what I would say to you.
At any rate, even if we pass this paper, there is an economic development deal that we have to come back to the committee.
Absolutely.
To the council for approval.
My recommendation would be we continue the paper for 30 days.
Help me, I'm not necessarily objecting to that, but help me understand again what the concern is, what you need done with this.
needs to be a filing done with the clerk of the courts, and that starts the meter running for 30 days, and it's not until the end of that 30-day period that the paper can be, that the bonds can be used for this purpose. And we could use it for the purposes that were originally in the paper, but not for this new purpose.
And Mike, there was also a request at the beginning of the meeting that we want this paper to be continued for some reason. Is this not the paper?
No.
My understanding is there was a necessity for it.
Good afternoon, Tabrina Renz with the City Attorney's Office. It's my understanding that there are certain requirements under the Public Finance Act that would require that the paper be continued, or at least continued to November the 12th. I don't have the specific details or provisions of the Act with me today, but I do, it's my understanding, and talking with members of my office, that that is something that needs to be done. The committee could take action on this paper in terms of any recommendations to approve or to deny or to reject the paper today, but it's my understanding that the council would need to continue it on Monday to the November 12th meeting per the requirements of the Public Finance Act. That's, I believe there's certain notice requirements as it relates to the paper itself.
Is that the same 30 days that doesn't do all this speaking in regards to?
I don't believe it's the same time frame. At least that was not communicated to me prior to me.
All right, then I guess if I'm clear, we have, if we take action to move this paper forward, there is still a necessity
to continue.
We cannot make it, we cannot actually take a vote on this paper in council. We would have to continue, is what you're saying. You're saying we can vote on it and continue it.
Well, no, what I'm saying is the committee could make a recommendation to the council as to whether to approve
would that be able
or to reject it.
Right,
it would have to be continued to the November 12th meeting.
Okay. All right, and does the finance committee meet before the November 12th meeting?
Yeah. Excuse me, Madam Chair. That does present a problem for us because the debt manager just talked about the time frame for getting it posted and us then being able to use it. This does relate to, as Councilman Tyler talked about, projects in the CIP, and what we do is we issue short-term debt, and that's a cash flow issue for us. And so for projects like the jail that we're working on, we anticipate we don't do the full long-term borrowing until we know exactly when we're going to need that money. And so to make this change now would be appropriate for us so that we can move forward and use our short-term debt to pay for monies that we know are coming up. It's a cash flow concern. So I haven't heard, we were not told anything about this other issue. I don't know if it is an issue because I'm just hearing it now, but I know that it is a concern for us.
I
continue the paper to November 12th, at which time the council as a body could take action on that paper because of certain requirements under the Public Finance Act.
So bottom line, Mr. Tyler has a motion to be... Thanks, sir. Mr. Tyler has a motion to be able to continue the hearing findings for 30 days. The administration is asking that we move it forward to council, and we all understand that even if we do that, there's no vote on Monday. It's still going to be continued to November 12th. That being the case, Madam Chair, I'd ask Mr. Tyler to consider whether or not that gives him sufficient time to get the information he needs.
Mr. Tyler?
Well, it would be a difference of 3 days.
Yeah, well, the other aspect of this, and I'm sitting here, if it's really 30 days, this goes to... Well, is it 30 days? If it's a true 30 days, then it's going to end up coming back to us in the last meeting in November, and not the first. So, I mean, you know, if it's a true 30 days. But with that being said, you know, we can move this paper forward. No matter. Well, let's split.
I just want to make sure that's clear. She said November 12th. That was my error. 30 days.
Oh, okay. Oh, wait a minute. Now, Mr. Jackson wants to say something.
I'm hoping I can simplify this to the point that everyone in the room can understand. There are two separate issues that are involved. The first issue is how quickly can council do anything. The second is, once council does something, how quickly can the money be used? The first question, how quickly can council do something, is answered by the Public Finance Act. There are publication requirements that will not allow you to act until November 12th. Once you act, assuming you approve on November 12th, there is a separate limitation that does not allow the money to be used for 30 days.
Thank you. Yes, appreciate that. All right.
My second point that I was going to make was, we could take, if we don't want to continue this paper, we can send this paper to council with no recommendation. And that would be my fallback position.
You have a second?
Yeah, I'll second that. I would even go so far as to be friendly movement to forward it to council with a recommendation to continue to November 12th. Guaranteed, nothing can happen.
That's fine.
We've been advised by the clerk that we should not, we can't make the recommendations of the continuation. So we have a motion, probably second, recommend the paper to council, to move the paper forward to council with no recommendation. All those in support say aye.
Aye.
Opposition, and we will forward this paper to council with no recommendation, with the hope that the question that is asked as to the reason why no recommendations being made can be addressed.
Madam Chair, if possible, we have informal, and I know Ms. Graziano left, but perhaps we could spend some time in informal, having an explanation from the administration with the backup documentation so that we have a full understanding. That's the first part. The second part is, I'm not sure the clerk, I didn't understand the clerk saying we couldn't do a continuance. That didn't make any sense to me.
Okay, she will explain that to you. The question that Ms. Patel is raising as it relates to the obligation that has already been made or is committed to be made in regards to the $175 million, if we could have some discussion on that as a part of the informal on Monday, Ms. Ollie.
I can't speak for the president, but I spoke with her earlier that there may be some potential changes relative to the informal agenda on Monday, and that may be difficult to get that discussion in on Monday.
All right, we'll make the request. If it cannot fit into the schedule, we would hope that the administration will take that into advisement, that there is a request for that information, and that could have an impact on the way the ultimate decision is made for approval. Mr. Clerk, can we go to the next paper?
Item numbers. Can I just get clarification? What was the vote on that?
The vote was
resolution number 2012-R133.
Thank you.